Hello everyone, I hope that you have completed your exercise. So let's start our question answers. So the lesson name is synthetic fibers and plastic. So in the exercise, first question is, explain why some fibers are called synthetic. So here you have to explain that the fibers are there. So there are two types of fibers, that is natural and synthetic. So here you have to explain that why some fibers are called synthetic. So let's start discuss the answer. The fibers which are not natural and made by human beings are called synthetic fibers, as they are manufactured by chemical processing of petrochemicals. So some fibers are natural, as they are just means we get from that nature, and that's why the fibers are known as natural fibers. And instead of that, some fibers are there that we cannot get from the nature. So that's why human beings are just made that fibers, and that's why the fibers are known as synthetic. So this is your first point. And the second point is, you have to write here some examples that these are made up of large units known as polymers, and examples of synthetic fibers are rayon, nylon, etc. So you can add here polyester and acrylic also. I have given two examples. So like that you have to explain that why some fibers are called synthetic. Okay. So next question is that, question 2, mark the correct symbol is there to the correct answer. Means we have to find out the correct option. So first is, rayon is different from synthetic fibers because, means here you have to write the reason that why rayon is different from synthetic fibers. So first option is, it has a silk-like appearance. Second one is, it is obtained from wood pulp. And third one is, its fibers can also be woven like those of natural fibers. So the answer is second one, that the rayon is obtained from wood pulp, means rayon is not a fully synthetic fiber, and that's why rayon is different from other synthetic fibers. Okay. Next question, that question 3, fill in the blanks with appropriate words. Here you have to fill the blanks. So first one is, synthetic fibers are also called dash dash or dash dash. Means here you have to write the other names of synthetic fibers. So the answers are, synthetic fibers are also called man-made or artificial fibers. So the answers are man-made or artificial. Next one, that is B, synthetic fibers are synthesized from raw material called dash dash. So as we know that the synthetic fibers we does not get from the nature, from the natural material. So that answer is petrochemicals. Yes, synthetic fibers are synthesized from raw material called petrochemicals. Don't forget that the raw material of synthetic fibers are petrochemicals. Next one is, like synthetic fibers, plastic is also a dash dash. Okay. In session that I have explained that the plastic, like synthetic fiber, plastic is also a polymer. Okay. That is made up of small repeating units. So I hope that you have written your all question 1, 2, 3 correctly. Now we will discuss about the question 4. The question 4 is that, give examples which indicate that nylon fibers are very strong. Okay. So from which thing, from which reason, we just saying that the nylon fibers are very strong, that you have to explain here. So first point is, nylon is a very strong fiber which is used for making parachutes, rock climbing ropes and fishing nets, etc. Moreover, it is used to make many articles such as socks, ropes, tents, toothbrushes, bags, curtains, etc. A nylon thread is elastic and light, but actually stronger than a steel wire. So from this 3 points, we can say that the nylon fibers are very strong, as we are using the nylon for making the parachute, ropes, some fishing nets, and other things are there like toothbrushes, bags, curtains. So as we learn in sessions that the properties of nylon, where the nylon is very elastic and lightweight, but still it is stronger than steel wire. So from these three points we can explain that. I hope that you are understanding all the question answers and you have written also. Next, question 5 is, explain why plastic containers are favored for storing food. Means why not we are using the glass container or metal containers, so instead of that we are using plastic containers. So just you have to write here reasons that why we are preferring the plastic containers. So see, plastic containers are favored for storing food because of following reasons. So many reasons are there, means here you have to explain the properties of plastic. So first property or first reason that why we are using plastic container is that they are easy to handle because of their light weight. Correct? So first one is because of light weight. We are saying that means we are preferring the plastic container. Next one is that they are cheaper when compared to other containers. Cheaper means what? Plastic containers can available in lower price. Next one, they are strong and durable. Okay, they are very strong and durable means what? We can use that for long time. Next one, they are non-reactive to moisture and air. Means they are not reacted with air, with moisture, so they cannot be corroded easily. See, I have written here, they are corrosion free. Means they cannot be rusted, and that's why we can use that for long time. So these are some reasons that why plastic containers are favored for storing food. So I hope that you have understand this answer. Next one, that explain the difference between thermoplastic and thermosetting plastics. So as I have given in sessions, online sessions, that already I have given the difference. Same I have given here. Okay. So first one, that why means what is mean by thermoplastic, what is mean by thermosetting, that you have to explain. So first point should be your definition, that plastic which gets deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are known as thermoplastics. And opposite to that, plastics which once molded and cannot be softened on heating are known as thermosetting plastic. So in first point, you have to explain the definition of both. Next, you have to write the examples. See the thermoplastic examples, that is polythene and PVC. And the example of thermosetting, that is bakelite and melamine. And in third, you have to write the applications, means which things are made up of thermoplastic and thermosetting, that you have to write. So I have written here for manufacturing of toys, combs and different containers. And of thermosetting, so bakelite is used for making electrical switches, handles of utensils, and melamine used for floor tiles, kitchenware and fabrics. Okay, so I hope that you have understand the difference between both types of plastics. Next one, that is question 7. Here also you have to write the reason. So the question 7 is that, explain why the following are made up of thermosetting plastic. Okay, thermosetting means what? They are not molded, or after heating they cannot soften. Okay, so first one is saucepan handles. So saucepan handles are made up of melamine, which is a thermosetting plastic, because it resists fire and can tolerate heat better than other plastic. So in saucepan handles, if we are using thermoplastic if we use, so that can be melt after heating. So to avoid that, we are using here melamine, which is an example of thermosetting plastic. Next one is that B1, that is electric plugs, switches and plug boards. Okay, here also we are using thermosetting plastic, as it is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. Means the bakelite is a poor conductor of heat and electricity, means what? The heat and electricity cannot pass through this plastic, and that's why we are using thermosetting plastic to make electric plugs, switches and plug boards. Okay. Next, question 8, that we have to just categorize the materials of the following products into can be recycled and cannot be recycled. Means which thing that we can use again by recycling and which things that we cannot be used after recycling. Means which things cannot be recycled and which thing can be recycled. So many things are there. I will explain or I will give the direct answers. That can be recycled products means that we can use after recycling is that plastic toys, carry bag, ballpoint pen, plastic bowls, plastic covering on electric wires and plastic chairs. So these things we can recycle and after we can use that. And cannot be recycled products means that is telephone instruments, cooker handles and electrical switches that cannot be recycled. Okay, so question 8, like I have given the answer, you have to write the answer. You can write here number wise also 1, 2, 3, like that also you can write. Next one is question 9. So the question 9 is that Rana wants to buy shirts for summer. Should he buy cotton shirts or shirts made from synthetic material? I have given the reason in online session. So you can write this answer in your own words. Also you can take help of this answer. So advise Rana giving you a reason. So the answer is Rana is advised to buy cotton shirts for summers because cotton shirt will absorb his sweat and cotton being a porous material will allow easy evaporation keeping his body cool. So evaporation means what? Water is just going outside from this from our body and that helps to keep our body cool. So this is advice to Rana that just buy cotton shirt. On the other hand, shirts made from synthetic material will not absorb sweat, making him feel warmer in summer. So in summer already the temperature is hot and if we are wearing the synthetic material, so we feel very uncomfortable. So that's why it is better option to buy cotton shirt. Okay, that question 9 answer you can write in your own words. Next one, question 10, give examples to show that the plastics are non-corrosive in nature. Non-corrosive means what? They are not reacting with moisture, with air. So that reasons or that answer is plastic containers are used for storing food, chemicals and other things as they do not react with water and air. So first, here you have to write that plastics are not reacting with water and air. Okay. Next one, that Teflon is used as coating on non-stick cookware. These plastics are not reacting and that's why we are using in many things. That also you have to write. Means here you have to actually write the examples, write the use and then you have to explain that the plastics are non-corrosive in nature. And the third point is that Bakelite is used for making electrical switches, handles of the utensils because it is a poor conductor of heat and electricity. So as you observe that the main points are there, they are just repeating. Okay, so just keep in mind all these things. Here the melamine is used for making floor tiles, kitchenware because it is a good fire resistance and can tolerate heat better than other plastics. So that also you have to write. Means again and again we are writing all these things that we have written in further ones, means in previous questions. So just do your homework, do your study properly that all the points are repeating. Okay, plastics means the main points in the exercise are whatever the examples are there and the properties are there that you have to learn. Next, question 11 is that should the handle and the bristles of toothbrush be made up of the same material? Explain your answer. So the handle that we are handling the brush, that handle and the bristles mean the thread like upper side part is there that are known as bristles. So that should be of same material. Can you tell me that should be of same material? No. Okay, the handle should be strong and the bristles should be soft. Okay, because we are just using that bristles to clean our gums and teeth. And if the bristle is strong, hard, so that can be harmful to our mouth. So the answer is no. The handle and bristles of toothbrush should not be made up of the same material. The bristles of a toothbrush should be made up of soft material so that it does not harm the gums, while the handle should be made up of hard material so that it can give a firm grip. If that handle is soft, we cannot just hold that brush and we cannot clean our teeth. So the handle should be of hard material. Okay. So hence bristles are usually made up of nylon, as they are very strong, elastic and light in weight. And the handle should be made up of plastic, which is strong and durable. Okay. Next question, question number 12. That is, avoid plastics as far as possible. Comment on this advice. Here also you have to write your personal opinion. So you can write in your own words. Here I have only written that how the plastic causes the harmfulness to the environment. So see, the plastics are non-biodegradable, so take several years to get decomposed. Next one, that plastic release lots of poisonous fumes into atmosphere on burning that cause air pollution. Means here you have to write the disadvantages of plastic. Next, the poly bags carelessly thrown are responsible for clogging the drains. Then the animals like cows might consume plastic, which might result in choking of their respiratory system and can even cause death. As we know that all animals are just feeding outside. They are eating whatever present in outside. So sometimes they are eating plastic also, that is very harmful to that animals. Next one, next disadvantages of plastic is soil pollution is caused because of plastic. Then threat to the aquatic animal is caused due to the plastic thrown away into the water bodies. That as we are just throwing the plastic in water, so the water pollution is there and that directly affect to the aquatic animal. So all these are the things that you have to write in question 12. You can also add your own points. Okay, don't copy from this. You can write in your own words also for question 12. Next is question 13, that is, match the terms of column 1 correctly with the phrases given in column 2. So you know that first here you have to write the column 1 and then in front of that you have to write the answers. So first is polyester and the answer is fabrics do not wrinkle easily. So polyester is one of the synthetic fiber that does not wrinkle easily. Teflon, that is used to make non-stick cookware. The coating on the non-stick cookware is of Teflon. Next one is rayon, that is prepared by using wood pulp. And the nylon is used for making parachutes and stockings. So I hope that you have written the question 13 easily and correctly. And the next question, question 14, is that manufacturing synthetic fibers is actually helping conservation of forest. Comment. Means here you have to write the advantages of synthetic fibers. Okay. So see, synthetic fibers are made fibers, are man-made fibers made from petrochemicals. Okay. So petrochemicals means what? Here we are not using the natural material. So the manufacturing of synthetic fibers does not require the cutting of trees, while natural fibers do require cutting of trees and even killing animals. Yes, the wool, silk, okay, that fibers we get from animals, and in silk, that silkworm actually boiling is there. So we are killing that animals. The cotton, when we are taking the cotton fibers, we are actually cutting the trees. So when we are using the synthetic fibers, so we can conserve forest by manufacturing them. So here you have to write the advantages of synthetic fibers. And the last question of your exercise is question 15. Describe an activity to show that thermoplastic is a poor conductor of electricity. Thermoplastic means what? That cannot tolerate heat. So that activity is there, that activity we will perform in our lab, because after that only you can understand this. But just see there, connect the circuit as shown in the figure below. So see, the switch is there, okay, battery is there, I have just joined, the thermoplastic is there, and one lamp is there. So we can understand that. So see, now when switch is closed, it is observed that lamp does not glow. This means that the thermoplastic is a poor conductor. So when we switch is closed, that switch is just closed, means we are just on the electricity that passes from these wires. But when we are adding the thermoplastic here, because of thermoplastic, the electricity cannot pass from this side, and that's why the lamp does not glow. And if we just replace the thermoplastic by a conductor, means on the other hand, if the thermoplastic is replaced by a conductor, then it is observed that the bulb glows. So thus we can conclude that thermoplastic is a poor conductor of electricity. So if in your circuit there is a thermoplastic is there, we cannot get the result properly. So from that we can understand that thermoplastic is a poor conductor of heat